Welcome to the lecture series on linear algebra. In the previous lectures, we have seen what a vector space is and we have seen several examples of a vector space and not a vector space as well. In this lecture, we are going to introduce something called subspace. Let us get into it. In order to define a subspace, first of all, we need a vector space. Okay? Let us denote that vector space as V of F, which means V is a vector space over the field F. Okay, a subset, some U in V is a subspace of V if U itself form a vector space over the same field, over the same field F. Okay, in this definition, just have a close look at it. Here I have mentioned a subset, which means I am talking about a non-empty subset only. Okay, I cannot take an empty set and say, trying to say that is a subspace of any vector space. It cannot be the case. Okay, it has to be non-empty subset. Okay, it is said to be a subspace of this vector space whenever this subset itself form a vector space over the same field. Here the same field is important. Now okay, we have seen some classical examples of vector spaces when we have dealt with vector spaces. Let me name few. Set of all complex numbers was a vector space over a set of reals, and complex was vector space over set of rationals as well. Complex was vector space over set of complex itself, right? Real was a vector space over set of reals, and real was a vector space over set of rationals, and rationals was a vector space over set of rationals. These were the cases that we have seen there. Okay, now may I treat among this is the super one as of now. Okay, can you identify a vector space for this? You have to take some subset and you have to prove that forms a vector space over C itself. It is quite complicated. So as of now, let us forget it, right? So let me take this. Okay, now we have four other sets, right? Whether these things form a vector space, sorry, subspace for this. Here this is a vector space over R. So look here, okay, among these, this is consider over Q, so this cannot be the vector subspace. Here it is also considered over Q, so this cannot be a subspace. This is also considered over Q, so this cannot be a subspace. This may be a subspace, right? So whenever we try to see something is a subspace or not, first look at the overfield. If it is given, it is the given vector space, just look at the overfield, then you may eliminate these options, right? And now some of us may ask a question that should we check all the axioms of a vector space? It is given in the statement, it means we have to do it, right? But we have a shortcut, a kind of equivalent statement that tells you, okay, U is a subspace of V over F if alpha U plus beta V belongs to U whenever U comma V is a member of V and alpha beta are the scalars taken from F. Hope you remember that the entries in F are said to be scalars and the entries in V, that is the vector space, are called as vectors. If this is going to happen, then we may say that as the subspace. Okay, using that idea, you can prove this is a subspace of this. Do we have any other subspace of that? Yes. set consisting of 0 over R is also a subspace of it. And this itself, this is the set of complex over R, is itself a subspace of that. As we have in the groups, rings, fields, here also we have two things, that is trivial subspaces and non-trivial subspaces. Okay, for any vector space, the trivial subspaces are a zero space over the field and the entire vector space over the field. These two are trivial subspaces. Any subspace apart from these two subspaces are called as non-trivial subspaces. Okay. Let me give one example. Consider R3 over R, which means I am talking about a three-dimensional thing. Okay, what will form a subspace here? Let me denote this in these names just for the convenience purpose. This represents some, this is a real line, this is another real line, and this is another real line. Together it forms a three-dimensional space. Okay, what can be its subspaces? As of now, let me take one thing and try to prove that is a subspace, and with the help of that, let me write all other possible subspaces. Okay, now let me consider this set alone. Okay, A is a member of R. This is the subset that I consider, which is non-empty, right? Now I have to take two elements from it. Let me take A00, let me take X just for the sake of convenience, plus some y00, right? And I have to take two scalars from this R as well. Let me have alpha and beta to be the scalars. The choice of these two vectors and these scalars are arbitrary here. What, how we have defined the scalar multiplication? We have defined the scalar multiplication in this sense. Alpha times of 0 is going to be 0, 0 here too. And this is going to be beta by 0, 0. So this is going to be the case, right? How we have defined the vector addition? It is alpha x plus beta y plus 0, 0. What are these x, y, alpha, beta, sir? Here the entries are taken from real. So x and y are real values. Alpha and beta scalars taken from real. Those are also real values. So this quantity is going to be some real value, which means what? I can say this is a member of U, because the first entry has to be some real value, the rest two entries has to be zero. That is the collection U. So this is in U. Therefore, this is a U is a subspace of V. That is R3 over R. Right? Now, using this idea, let me collect. Okay, here what have I taken? I have taken some point on this line. Okay, and I proved that is a subspace. Similarly, if I take any points on this line, okay, this line alone I am going to consider, I can prove that also a subspace. I take this line and I can prove this also a subspace, which means the possible subspaces right now are this, okay, and this, and this. Okay, can we find any other subspaces? Just looking at it, we have considered these three lines. Now we may try for these three planes. Okay, for that, let me consider only this thing, where x and y are taken from here. Here what is going to happen? Let me take alpha times of x1, y1, 0 plus beta times of x2, y2, 0, and it is going to be alpha x1 plus beta x2, alpha y1 plus beta y2, 0. Since alpha x1, y1, beta x2, y2 all these entries are real. This is a member of, suppose if we take this collection to be a let me see, W, this is a member of W, right? Here, what have I done? I have taken a point here, okay? I have taken the points over this plane and I proved that is a subspace. So similarly, I can collect the points on this plane as well as on this plane too. So here, what is going to happen? I am going to collect xy0 where x and y are real entries, and similarly I can go with this where x and z are real entries. Remember the notations x, y, z, these are simply notations, which means you have to take some real entries at these places. The places are important, not the names. Okay, sorry, here we have chosen this. So 0, y, z, and y and z are members of R. Right? These are happening. In notation, what is this? This is simply R cross R cross R over R. Right? So if I write these things in the notation, what am I going to get? Here it is R cross Z0. Okay, and this is going to be Z0 cross R cross Z0. And this is going to be Z0 cross R, right? And this is going to be R cross Z0. And this is R cross Z0 cross R. And this is Z0 cross R, right? So we have collected these six subspaces for this. Do we have any more? Yes. Just before, I have told you that about the trivial subspaces, which means the zero set, that means 0 cross 0 cross 0 and the entire vector space. These are all subspaces of this vector space, and these two are called trivial subspaces, and these six subspaces are non-trivial subspaces. Hope you have understood the concept of subspace and how to find the subspaces. In the upcoming lectures also, we are going to work out few more problems on subspaces. If you have any queries, you can post it in the comment section. That will be clarified within 24 hours of time. Thank you for watching this lecture.